Hey there, Gavin Gear here from the Extreme Windows blog, and today I want to show you how Oculus Rift can give you a glimpse into the future of PC gaming. Now, I'm a big fan of racing and simulation games, and these games basically share the same interaction model. You're doing two things in terms of input. You're controlling the vehicle, and you're controlling your point of view. Now, this can be complicated with a single controller. You'll often need to pan your view with one controller, like a hat controller on a joystick, and then you're going to need to drive the vehicle with another set of controls, like tilting the joystick, that kind of thing. Same sort of thing on a gamepad. Now, this really creates an artificial scenario. You don't have to control your point of view when you're driving a real car, obviously. This is where Oculus Rift can come to the rescue. Oculus Rift has integrated motion tracking sensors. There's a 3D accelerometer, there's a 3D gyro, and there's a 3D magnetometer. And Oculus takes these inputs and merges them together with what's called sensor fusion so that it can have very responsive, very accurate, and very fluid head tracking. And it's also a stereoscopic 3D display. This is an awesome new experience for PC gaming. In this video, I'm going to use a desktop PC with an NVIDIA GeForce 780 Ti graphics card. I've got a display that I'm using for reference here. I'm going to use an Xbox controller to drive the vehicle, and I'm going to use Oculus Rift for head tracking and display. The game that I want to show you is Euro Truck Simulator 2. So running Euro Truck Simulator 2 with Oculus Rift is actually pretty easy. All I had to do was enlist in the public beta for Oculus Rift support on Steam, install that version, and launch the game with the Oculus command line parameter. When you do so, and when you start a game session, you're going to see the stereo view on your display. And when you put the Oculus headset on, you're going to be immersed in the virtual cockpit of the truck, which is really cool. It might be a little bit disorienting momentarily or for a couple minutes, but overall, you just look around and you can see the interior of the truck, you can see the road. It's really cool. So I'm going to start up the truck here. And we can even look out the window. So if we look towards the window and then we look back, we can see what's behind us. It's totally cool. So I'm going to use my Xbox controller and start to drive down the road. And this is really neat. We can see out the side window when we're going. We can keep track of our instrumentation on the truck. Everything is really realistic in this game, which is, of course, what simulators are all about, is recreating an experience. And I'm just kind of not feeling too patient, so I'm going to go around these people. Hope I don't get in trouble here. It's a really cool experience. It really does give you a glimpse at what virtual reality can be like in games. Whoops, going the wrong way here. The resolution of this current development kit is not high enough to give you a full legible view of heads-up displays, engages, that kind of thing. I was able to try the 1080p version at PAX this year and was really, really impressed with what that looks like. But this development kit is really about enabling developers and about giving people a preview of the experience. In terms of developing the technology, I think Oculus has done a really awesome job with the development kit. So I'm going to have to get my bearings here and learn how to use this a little better. I also think a steering wheel shifter and pedals is going to be a definite upgrade for this experience. Well, I'm really excited to see where this technology goes. And if you want to experience it for yourself, I'd recommend that you go to oculusvr.com, where you can check into their affordable development kits. And if you want to see a complete list of Oculus Rift supported games for the PC platform, please check out the accompanying Extreme Windows blog post. That's it for now. Thanks.